Mother's Day. I am dedicating this haul to all of you mothers out there who are slaying it in the game. No matter what you're doing, being a mom is definitely hard work. So this haul goes out to you guys, and a lot of the things that I purchased in this haul were for Mother's Day, or are for Mother's Day, because Mother's Day hasn't happened yet. But I just wanted to send that message across loud and proud that our day is here, moms. Oh, it's coming. So anyways, today I'm super excited about this haul because guess what? Look. Oh my gosh, it's finally here. The watermelon juice sparkling beverage, finally here. So if you guys wanna learn more about this beverage, stay tuned, watch the haul. I kinda go a little bit in depth about this. I also wanted to give you guys a little sneak peek of the hand wash I'm gonna be showing you guys. And dangerous, these sprinkle cookies walk into a bar, and yes, there is frosting in the middle. So if you guys want to know the nutrition facts and all about these, stay tuned, watch the haul, and you will find out. Now if you guys want to see myself, my husband, and my son taste test these new items, please check out the next video following this haul video. It's a taste test, so I'll be showing all those things. And if you guys like these hauls, please give it a thumbs up. It helps my channel out a lot. And subscribe if you haven't already. I do Trader Joe's hauls once a week, followed with a taste test, as always. All right, that's all I have to say today, so let's check out what I bought for this week. All right, ooh, baby, just hold tight. We're up the moonlight, believe in the magic. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and kick off the haul right here, starting with just some classic go-to corn tortilla chips. Now, these are my favorite all-time, like, best tortilla chip. I always go back to these, even when Trader Joe's comes out with a new tortilla chip. These are just, like, all around great for everything, chips and salsa, any other recipe that calls for tortilla chips. These are my go-to every single time, so I like to have these in our pantry at all times. And with the new salsa, which I did buy another one, I'll show you guys in a second, these chips and that salsa, oh my gosh, the best snack in the world. Maybe not in the world, but it is a delicious snack. Now moving on to the ghost pepper potato chips. These are another one of my absolute favorites. If you guys like spicy, some bags are spicier than others. I've found I really can't tolerate some of them. They're just so hot that I have to, you know, maybe have like five and then put the bag away. Then there's other bags where I can just have tons and never feel like it's so spicy that I can't handle it. So that's the only thing I have to say, is just like sometimes they're hotter than others, but I love that they're the ridge cut. It's like the best type of cut, I think, or lattice cut they call it. And it just holds all the seasoning, and it's just such a great flavorful seasoning. Now I was talking about the salsa that goes good. I'm gonna just skip over to that real quick just to show you guys. It's the new organic salsa. I showed this in a previous haul. I am addicted. I love this salsa, it's so good. I've been actually putting it on my taco salads, and let me just tell you, it's like a game changer in breakfast burritos in the morning. Like, this salsa has been getting a ton of use, so this is actually my third container of it in like 2 weeks. I very much like it so much, and it's fresh, so it is refrigerated in the, usually like where all the hummus and stuff is at Trader Joe's, at least at my Trader Joe's. Now we're jumping back over. So as you guys obviously know, Mother's Day is Sunday, and I want mimosas. So I just grabbed a cheap champagne that Trader Joe's sells. I should say inexpensive. It's the RSVP Brut. I don't mind having like a less expensive champagne because I'm mixing it. Now my favorite go-to, if you guys have been watching me, you know, tangerine juice is my go-to mimosa mixer. I love Trader Joe's tangerine juice. It's just so, I don't know how to explain it. It's better than orange juice. It has a lot of flavor, and it has like a, just a different hint of sweetness than traditional orange juice does. So
I like this combo always. I'm gonna buy another bottle of champagne from Costco, I think, and then bring that over to my mom's house because I'm seeing my mom on Mother's Day. And yeah, so that's what that's for. I also picked up a couple herbs. So I got this mint and I got this basil. Trader Joe's sells the organic ones in a small like container like this, and then the non-organic basil is in a much bigger pot, but I'm actually gonna be planting these in my garden, so they're gonna grow huge, and so that's why I grabbed them, and they just looked gorgeous. I mean, look at how tall this mint plant is. It's happy, so is this basil, so I can't wait to plant it and then just have mint and basil year round. Well, it doesn't last all year, but at least for the summer season, I will have that, and I will never have to buy another little batch again that goes bad anyway. So got some pretzel slims. These are great with hummus. One of our favorite snacks is pretzels and hummus. Also just good to just munch on whenever. Now let's take a look at the wines I purchased. So I wanted to show you guys a couple examples of some really delicious and affordable wines. Two of these, as you guys see, the Pass is from New Zealand and Picton Bay, both New Zealand wines. I found that wines that come from New Zealand are just like, they're just above the rest as far as taste goes, price goes. They're just really clean, easy to drink, light wines. So as you guys can see, they're both Sauvignon Blancs. They are very light, kind of fruity, but definitely more on like the taste like water side. It definitely doesn't taste like water, but if you guys know what I mean. They're just really easy, light to drink. Hot days are the best. You can make wine spritzers with these. Just add a little sparkling water, a little squeeze of lemon or lime, your choice. It's just all around delicious, and they're very affordable. So I highly recommend, if you guys want just like a light drinking wine for when it gets hot, these are great options. This, the Big Churn, is a great Chardonnay. I've been sharing this with you guys for the past, I think, year, almost maybe year and a half. And it's like my go-to Chardonnay. The price you can't beat. The flavor is just, it's perfect. It's the best Chardonnay for the price that I have found in a long time. Of course, there are better Chardonnays, but they obviously are going to entail a higher price. So that's a great Chardonnay. Now this one, I also swear by. This is the Susa Maniello, and it is a red wine, but it is amazingly delicious. And for the price, it tastes like a wine that you would get at a winery. It's so good. I've bought probably 20 bottles of this just here and there. I gift these all the time because they're just such a great wine. And this wine really tastes much more expensive than it is. So here are just a few I thought maybe you guys would want to know before Mother's Day, so that way you have something to get, buy, enjoy. Moving on to some frozen items now. I got some tater tots. I'm actually going to make my tater tot egg bake casserole. I've shared this with you so many times. I have a video on it. It is such an easy breakfast to pre-make, so I'm gonna be making this the night before Mother's Day, popping it in the fridge, and then baking it in the morning. That way you don't even have to worry about getting any dishes out, making a mess, trying to whip up something for breakfast. It's ready to go. You just cook it and then serve. It's super easy. So tater tots for that. Tim wanted some more latkes. These potato latkes are so delicious. We put boursin on them. I know some people are gonna be like, they're supposed to be sour cream or applesauce. I get it. I've tried it with both. Both of those options are great. Boursin is next level. Just saying. Like, if you guys have had boursin and you like it, it's just, it's next level. So that's why Tim likes these. He'll just slather it with boursin and call it a day. But yeah, so got those. I got the stuffed gnocchi. I haven't bought this in forever. If you guys haven't had this yet, it's basically like a little pizza roll. There's the gnocchi stuffed with tomato sauce and mozzarella, and you just kind of like bite into it and just all this ooey gooey goodness comes out of it. It's just a delicious, easy to make meal or lunch, whatever you want to do with it, but this comes in frozen. Highly recommend trying it at least once. Got some black bean and cheese taquitos. These are a staple. I haven't bought them in a while, but with this salsa, you know what I'm saying? Gotta get it. Next up, I'm gonna show you guys some fruit. So my family and I have been on a fruit kick. Clearly, Benson has gotten into some of these fruits. I can't even get home and put away these groceries before Benson wants me to whip him up a little fruit bowl, which I don't mind because fruit is so healthy and so delicious during the summer. Everything is so sweet and juicy right now. So I got some blueberries, some raspberries, some strawberries, and then these are new. These are called the Sapphire Grapes, black seedless grapes, and they're the weirdest grapes I've ever seen, to be totally honest. When I first saw these, and Tim told me not to say this on here, but they look like toes, like long toe grapes. So I call them toe grapes. I know that's really weird and it's unappetizing, but they're actually very good, surprisingly. This whole thing was filled. Benson has nonstop been asking me for these grapes since I gave him one. So I've been giving him these grapes throughout the day, and he is the weirdest kid ever. He'll eat it, biting into the middle. I don't know. He's a strange one, but these grapes are so good. I highly recommend getting them, even though they look kind of weird. Next up, I got some beefless ground beef. Now, this is just for adding to pasta sauce. Stuffed bell peppers is a great idea. I need to buy some bell peppers, but I was thinking this for just adding to sauce with all the new noodles that I have. I think this would be a really good addition to just make it a little more hearty and filling. So that's why I grabbed that. Now I'm gonna show you all the cheese I got. Now this is for Mother's Day also. My mom has requested that I bring some cheese. She has some crackers and stuff. I'm also gonna be purchasing a baguette probably the day before just so it's fresh, but my mom loves her brie with a baguette, and so do I. It's actually a really good combo. But I wanted to show you guys the cheeses I chose for Mother's Day. So I got the triple cream brie. This is amazing, especially if you put the pepper jelly on it from Trader Joe's. It's so good. I also got the Toscano cheese soaked in Syrah. This is also just an easy classic go-to. This is the Gouda that's aged for a long time, I think. It has like the little crunchies in there. I love this kind of cheese. And then the last one was another brie that has, it's triple cream and it has mushrooms in it. So you guys can see, I really just tried to get my mom a little variety of everything, but her favorite's brie, so that's why I got two of them. Now, I am gonna go ahead and show you guys the Spotlight Cheese of the Month. This is super interesting. It's not only really cute and pretty, it's shaped like a little flower. It's called Dorothy's Keep Dreaming Soft Ripened Cheese, Complex and Savory. Now, this, why this caught my eye is because in the back, there is no rennet in here, but it says vegetable ash, and I actually had to ask a couple of my friends if they knew what that was. Apparently, they use it to, and correct me if I'm wrong, but this is what I've been told, is they use it to decipher whether the cheese was made in the morning or the afternoon. But in this instance, someone told me that it was probably used to rub on the rind, and the rind does look like dark, so it makes sense that there'd be like vegetable ash, and I believe it is edible. I don't know why it wouldn't be, but just an interesting little tidbit. If you guys know more about this, let me know in the comments below. I love learning all these things, and some of you guys just know everything. You're knowledgeable about every subject, so I love that. So I really can't wait to try this cheese and the taste test. It's gonna be a good one, I think, and I'm just really curious about this whole vegetable ash thing, so hopefully I'll find out before I shoot that haul or the taste test to try it, because I don't know if it's edible or not. I think it is though. Okay, now we finally arrived at the new and seasonal items. So I'm gonna start here with the organic coleslaw kit. This actually came out last year, and it's apparently seasonal. I kind of forgot about it, to be honest. It has green cabbage, red cabbage, carrots, and a creamy sweet dressing that is separate. You can make it yourself. This, I remember tasting a little more sweet than savory, and I do like a more tangy dressing for like, even if it is coleslaw, but it is really easy. This kit is super easy to use and make for whatever you want coleslaw with. You can just eat it plain, or you can add it to like even like a fish taco or something like that. But it's exciting that it's organic, and it's actually just very convenient. I know a lot of people will make their own coleslaw dressing, and I think it's super easy. So you could always do that in replace of the actual dressing that comes in here, or you could maybe just add a little vinegar to the dressing and it might help hang it up a bit. So that's just my only thing on this, but it is delicious, it's fresh, and it's here for a limited time. Next up is a cookie that I didn't think our Trader Joe's was gonna get. This is the cranberry and white chocolate oatmeal cookie. You've seen me haul the other two flavors that this has come out with. These come in frozen. They're oatmeal. This one is an oatmeal cookie with sweetened dried cranberries and white chocolate chunks. This looks too good to be true, honestly. These look so good. I like white chocolate. I know a lot of people don't, but I really do. So I'm really excited to try these. I'm probably gonna take these to my mom's house too, so we can all have like a little cookie and enjoy ourselves. Next up is something that I've never seen Trader Joe's ever carry. This is a yeast brick, I'm gonna call a yeast brick, because it is just a big brick, airtight, air sealed of yeast. And I think they came out with this because so many people have been trying to find yeast and it's been really hard. Usually Trader Joe's comes out with yeast during the holidays, and it's usually in that 3-pack that you see that has like individual packets attached. But that's not usually until like November time. So it's kind of really cool that they've come out with this. It's a pound, it's a ton of yeast. And a customer actually told me that you can freeze this so it doesn't actually expire when it says it does. You can freeze it and it'll last a lot longer. So yeah, that's what I plan on doing, because I don't think I can use a full thing of yeast before this expires, you know what I mean? Next up is the new Meyer Lemon Cake Mix. Well, it's not new, it is a seasonal item. I bought this last year. This is such a great cake. I love lemon during the summer. Meyer lemons are a big hit. So this is just an all-around delicious cake. It's seasonal, so I say grab a couple. I got two so far. And I'm gonna be making this for Mother's Day also, because it's just really yummy. So if you wanted to know what you need for this, you just need an egg, a cup of water, half a stick of butter, and a loaf pan. So that's it. And then, oh, and then for the glaze, you just need the glaze mix, hot water, and melted butter. But yeah, really delicious, easy to make cake, so yummy. This is a brand new flavor that the Go Macro Bars just came out with, or at least they brought it into Trader Joe's. I'm sure that's been around, but it's the oatmeal chocolate chip. It's organic, vegan, and gluten-free. So it's nice and convenient to have these just grab and go. Not like we're going anywhere, but you know, maybe you don't wanna make breakfast one morning. I don't know. I'm sure a lot of you guys have been seeing this floating around Instagram. It's the Ube Mochi Pancake and Waffle Mix. It's a chewy mochi pancake mix with purple yam. Hello, this is so fun. I cannot wait to try this. This is gonna be happening on the taste test. You guys, just wait. I can't wait to see what this is gonna taste like. It is gluten-free. And it just says add water, eggs, and butter, and you're good to go. So there are 6 servings per container. Serving size is a 1/6 of the dry mix. If you calculate 2 prepared pancakes, it's 310 calories, 9 grams fat, 420 milligrams sodium, 53 grams carbs, less than 1 gram of fiber, 13 grams of sugar, and 7 grams of protein. So you see that? Interesting, very interesting. Can't wait. I really can't. I'm not skipping over these. These are something that my child, inner child, is just screaming. These look so amazingly good. I love sprinkles. I mean, to this day, I love sprinkles. So seeing these cookies just brings me joy. It makes me happy. It's called These Sprinkles Walk Into a Sandwich Cookie. Very colorful, looks just, I don't know. I just want to open them right now and eat them. They're butter cookies filled with buttercream frosting and sprinkles. I mean, come on. Come on, Trader Joe's, I'm trying to be good. Here's the nutrition facts for those of you that really wanna know. I know I don't, because I'm gonna be eating one of these in the taste test, but one cookie is 140 calories, 8 grams of fat, 60 milligrams of sodium, 19 grams of carbs, 0 fiber, 9 grams of sugar, and less than 1 gram of protein. So yeah, that's what you're getting out of this. There is milk and wheat in here, in case you guys wanted to know. But yeah, these look just too good. I'm so excited about them. Now, here is a new beer. I only bought one because it's quite expensive. I think for 4, it was $14 plus CRV. And I just first of all, I love the artwork on here. It's just really interesting. It's fun. It looks kind of like a video game. So this beer is called Browridge West. It's Picnic Lightning and it's hazy. So what I got from this is that it's a hazy IPA. I'm not an IPA drinker, but because it's hazy, it's actually kind of creamy and it brings out more of the citrusy flavors. So I'm really excited to try this and see if it's still too much, too hopsy for me. Another thing to note is these are 6.8%, so they're very strong, meaning that you really only need one. And I think Tim and I are gonna share this and we're gonna be tasting it in the taste test. But if you want to buy this, just keep that in mind because they're very high on the percentage of alcohol. Next up is the brand new tomato ketchup with black summer truffle. Very interesting. This looks like a really nice, fancy ketchup for those fancy picnics that we're all gonna be having in our backyards. But yeah, this is new to Trader Joe's, and if you like truffle, this is probably gonna be really good. The nutrition facts in the back are just 15 calories per serving, which is one tablespoon, only 2 grams of sugar, and that's really what I'm gonna go over with this one. So if you guys can see the ingredients, just give you guys a quick peek. There are natural flavors. Other than that, it looks just like a lot of spices and seasonings and stuff like that. Now, as you guys can see, I bought 3 packages of the sparkling watermelon juice, and that's only because I was carrying the bags out of work and I didn't have a shopping cart because it was way after we closed, and I could only carry up to 3 of these at a time. So I would have bought more, honestly. This is something I have been patiently waiting for, since you guys all know I've been talking about it for weeks since I've been showing you guys the strawberry one. The watermelon's finally here. Woohoo! If you guys haven't tried this, go to Trader Joe's whenever you're gonna do your shopping and grab one. Just do yourself a favor. This is all natural, by the way. This is just watermelon juice and what is it? And carbon dioxide, citric acid, ascorbic acid to maintain color. So there are a couple preservatives in there, but it's just basically sparkling watermelon juice. And it is the most tasty, delicious sparkling water I have pretty much ever had. And it tastes just like watermelon because that's what it is. So love that. Got a brand new soap in, and I love this because it's really big. It's great price point, and it's lavender. I love the scent of lavender. It's just calming. It smells amazing. This says it cleanses and invigorates the senses. It's just really simple. I like that because you can put it in your bathroom or anywhere in your house, and it's not like an eyesore. And it's good timing because we should all be washing our hands extra, extra, extra. So this is a brand new hand soap that they came out with. I'm really curious to try this and see how it is. It does say it's made in the USA. I know a lot of people like seeing that to support businesses within the USA. But yeah, that's the new soap. And then last but not least, we got the frozen cheese enchiladas. And I am thinking these were not only reformulated, they have a new packaging, obviously. Previously, Trader Joe's sold a cheese enchilada that was frozen, but it totally didn't look like this. This is new packaging, like I said. The reason why I think it's reformulated is because look on here, expeller pressed soybean oil. I can bet that there was not expeller pressed oil in this beforehand. So just letting you guys know, if you liked these and you were hesitant because of the oil use, I know expeller pressed is much better. I know soybean oil is not the best oil, but still, just letting you guys know, these are back at Trader Joe's, and I am gonna try these in the taste test too. So I'll let you know how they taste, and yeah, we'll go from there. So this is it, guys. This is the haul for this week. I did put the frozen stuff away. It's 95 today and I didn't want it to melt. So anyways, this is it. And yeah, hope you liked it. All right, well that does it for this week's haul. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I kind of want to give you guys who watch till the end and watch this like outro that I do a little sneak peek in maybe the next week's haul, because yes, I did another shopping trip in between this one because I needed more stuff. And as you guys know, I work at this grocery store, so I'm able to pick up these items while I'm at work. I'm not just
going back and forth every day to the store, so don't come for me, guys. But I did want to share with you guys this Prosecco. This is the Zonin Prosecco. This is one of my absolute favorites. It's so amazing on its own, but it's also great with mimosas. And I am gifting this to my mother-in-law because I know she likes Prosecco. And this one is like a tried and true. And for those of you guys that are really interested in beer, this new beer just came in, I think like maybe a week ago, but I decided to pick it up. Anytime I see the words IPA or the letters IPA, it scares me off. But I see this tropical too and the packaging. I mean, I decided to just give it a try. So this will be in the next haul and I'll go more into detail. And of course I'll be tasting it in that taste test, but I wanted to give you guys a little sneak peek because I appreciate you that watched the whole video and watched till the end. So if you did watch till the end, comment about either the beer or the Prosecco so that people that are reading the comments are confused if they don't watch the end. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this haul. Please give it a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel. Like I said, I do Trader Joe's hauls once a week, always showing all the new stuff, all the seasonal stuff, and doing the taste test in a separate video. So I hope you guys enjoyed it. Have a wonderful day and happy Mother's Day to all you beautiful mamas out there. See you guys in my next video. Bye.